So today we're going to work on this aerobic treatment plant, our treatment system, air pump. This goes on a septic system. Red lights on here when you plug it in, the pump doesn't come on. It's probably going to be these diaphragms, like this here. These come off another pump I've already rebuilt. They go bad, it cuts the switch off inside and this red light will come on, the pump won't work. So we're going to take this apart, rebuild it. Before working on the unit, make sure it's unplugged or disconnected from the outlet and doesn't have any power coming to it. First thing you want to do is take this filter off, this filter cover. This one here is definitely dirty. Lay that off to the side. Take these four bolts here, 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 and here off. You can use a Phillips head. Sometimes a Phillips head won't get them. You have to use a nut driver or socket. Use a 5/16 socket. The bolts here and here will hold this test unit, alarm unit on. Just take this down out of the way. The top off. Now that we have the cover off, and take the insulation material off the motor, lay it to the side. So now we got the insulation off, you can take your clamps off. You can usually move these by hand. Sometimes you have to have pliers, take a flathead screwdriver, move the hoses. Then you can take the diaphragm and check valve assembly off. It'll be four bolts. That'll be a Phillips head. They're definitely bad. Take a 9/32 socket. Take the diaphragm off. Broke all the way off. Take the diaphragm off this side. Here's a new kit. That's your two diaphragms here. It's your check valve. It's the filter. This is the brake screw that cuts the unit off. This unit here has the micro switch. So all you do is move this white thing back over. It engages the switch and it'll be ready to go. You might have to put a screw in it. So that's not needed. Come with new bolts, get the diaphragms. So I'm gonna install this diaphragm here. The diaphragm is shaped just like this hole right here. This little notch over here goes over here. Notch is going to go in this notch here. We have to push this across. Get your hand on the other side. So on these diaphragms, there's two raised edges. The motor block fits in between it. It's square. Make sure that square goes in between those two raised edges when you bolt it up. This is what it should look like when it's bolted up. The diaphragm with the motor block and then two raised edges. Now that we have the diaphragms on, you can put your check valves on. The check valve has a notch in here. It's grooved out that matches up with this notch over here on this side. This also lines up with this hose. You can go ahead and stick it on this hose here. And put it over the top. You put your four screws in it. plant back on your hose and turn around and do that end. Same thing on this end. There's a notch cut out here. There's a notch sticks out here, and then this goes on your hose. Hose clamp on. Now we got the diaphragms on each end. And set the switch back so this will be on. This pump is ready to come on now if you plug it in. So if you're rebuilding an older unit that has the brake screw on it, this is what cuts the pump off. This piece here pivot back and forth. Whenever the diaphragms go bad, it'll break this screw and this brass tab will come off. That'll open the circuit to close that circuit back off. To make this pump work, you stick a screw here through there. Put the nut on it. Tighten it up, that'll push that brass tab back over. It'll actually stop tightening once it gets to where it's supposed to go with the red stuff. And that'll close the circuit, the pump will be ready to come on. Now that we have the micro switch engaged and the diaphragm's all done, you can put this insulation back on. Put the cover back on. Take a 5/16 socket and your nut driver, tighten all these up. Take the top of the unit. Put your new filter in. So when you plug this pump in, this light's going to come on because there's no back pressure on the hose here going to the septic tank or treatment plant. So plug it in. The light's going to be on. Put your hand over the end. Put pressure on it. The light will go off. You want to see if the alarm works. Put the alarm on. Cover it up. The alarm should go off.